Hey guys, Kate and Blake here from Farm Bred. We are doing some yard work on a Saturday morning. Girls don't like to be disturbed in their nesting boxes. So we are doing some cleaning out of our coop. We have hemp bedding, which is awesome because it really helps with the absorption of the chicken poo, but also with the smell. So we love our hemp bedding. And we also don't have to clean it out as often because it comes together really nicely. So what we've been doing is we have our hemp bedding in the coop. Today we did a good cleaning of that. You'll see there's still a ton that we left. And then we're going to put fresh hemp on top of it. Now that the days are getting colder, we want to have a thicker bedding than we do in the summertime. Just for the chickens to help with heat over the winter. So I'm gonna apply some like fresh hemp bedding down today. We got a few bags. The thing with hemp bedding is, as amazing as it is, it's a little bit more expensive. It's an investment, but it's worthwhile because you're not changing it as frequently. The problem is with the supply chain being so disrupted, it's been really hard to get it. So I've been placing orders for it. And so if you can get it, I would suggest it. Because I don't know when it's going to be back in stock. You don't know when it's going to be back in stock. So it's kind of a hot commodity these days with chicken owners. But so I'm going to put more hemp down in both. We've got a stall over there too, which the chickens, they can go in and out of both of them and then into our covered run. So what I do, what's an amazing fertilizer for your garden is the chicken manure. But Louie's got something to say. Any chicken owner knows that you cannot put chicken manure directly on the garden after it's laid. You need it to you need it to rest a while. Usually they say it takes about 6 months. This chicken manure is just too strong. I believe it's the nitrogen. I don't quote me on that, but the makeup of the chicken poo is just too strong to grow stuff right away. So what I like to do is do a nice fall cleaning, put all of that chicken manure on our garden in the fall so that we get our garden beds ready so that by the time the spring comes, we have an awesome fertilizer for our garden and our garden beds are ready. Here's our lovely Freya. So now after I showed you how we cleaned out down here, I'll show you how I throw the chicken manure into our garden, and then I'll rake it in. I still need to clean out our garden beds, throw out the dead stuff. They actually say that sometimes you can leave that dead stuff because it helps with the soil nutrients. So I might just kind of rake everything in together and then do a good spring cleaning, but by that point, all the good nutrients will still be in the soil. And a lot of that decomposition will be in the soil as well. So I'll show you how I just pile it over into our garden. I'll show you what it looks like. And then I'll come back and show you what I've been doing with our leaves because it's the fall. And we've got a lot of leaves around. And leaves, or I should say chickens, love leaves. So it's like a big playpen for them. So we're here at our little garden shed by our garden. Blake brought Barbara to come check it out with us. But yeah, here, you'll see I've still left everything in here. Oh, our kitty cat King is coming out to say hey. He's one of our barn cats that we got this August, and he's amazing. We love him. He's super friendly. We've got Nellie too. She's a little bit more shy. King is super affectionate. Always wants to be by us when we come outside. But yes, you'll see here, I've just kind of piled up the chicken manure. You'll see there's a lot of hemp bedding still in there, which is totally fine. That decomposes really nicely in the garden as well. Here's our awesome leaf pile. You can see the girls are already exploring it, scratching around. They just love the leaves. And what's really cool is you're helping to remove leaves from your yard, but there's tons of bugs and little critters inside these leaves that the chickens love to go for, scratch around for. And as they scratch around, they break the leaves up. The leaves then in turn start to decompose and degrade. creating a really nice robust dirt and soil for your chicken run. So our chicken run is totally enclosed, so we wouldn't naturally get leaves in here. But so that's a great thing to do if you have a enclosed or a covered chicken run. Go rake your yard and throw the leaves in for your chickens. I also pulled some weeds at the same time, and that's a great way to weed and then give some nutrients to your chickens as well. I seriously could not have asked for a better day. It is gorgeous outside. As you can see, we still have a lot of leaves we've got to rake up. But yeah, I hope that's been helpful, offering some tips for what you can do with your chicken manure, how to fertilize your garden with the awesome chicken manure, and also clean out your coop, getting ready for winter, and then how you can repurpose your leaves in your yard. Once you do a nice raking in your yard, just throw those leaves into your chicken run, your chicken pasture, wherever. It's a great resource for them for nutrition, gives them something to do, and yeah, helps you clean your yard at the same time. So if you're enjoying this content, always we always appreciate it. Like and subscribe, and I'll share some more helpful tips, and yeah, we'll take it from there. Have a great day, you guys. Hope you have as beautiful a day as we do here in Connecticut. Thanks. Bye.